Let the sky fall, let it crumble. We will stand tall and face it all together. Howdy, hey there, and hello. I'm Montez McCrary, the Practitioner Nerd, and I love geeking out about architecture, technology, video games, professional wrestling, and nerd and geek culture in general. And yes, I am very excited about Skyfall coming out on Blu-ray and DVD next week. I can't wait to add it to my other collection of James Bond movies and collections. I just started recollecting them again, and I saw Skyfall twice. I really enjoyed it, and you know what? I can't wait to add another movie. I can't wait to add another movie to my collection, and I am just very excited. And when I get excited, I like to sing along with things, and I like listening to music like this album by Descendants of Eric. See, it has all the members here. All of them are, wait, someone's missing. And boom. Go pick this up. It's called Downright Heavy. Get it? Get it? Anyways, stories. Norma Skarlerik was the first African-American woman to be licensed as an architect in the United States. She was also the first to be licensed in the state of New York in 1954, and the first African-American woman to be licensed as an architect in the state of California in 1962. She was also the first woman to be elected fellow of the American Institute of Architects and established the first architectural firm to be formed and managed by an African-American woman in 1985, Siegel, Skarlerik, and Diamond, which was the largest woman-owned and mostly woman-staffed architectural firm in the United States. Some of Skarlerik's projects included the San Bernardino City Hall in San Bernardino, California, of course, the Fox Plaza in San Francisco, Terminal 1 at LAX, and the Embassy of the United States in Tokyo, Japan. After retiring, she served on the California Architects Board. She was the chair of the AIA National Ethics Council. She was designated an honorary member of Delta Sigma Theta. Yeah, that was my mom. She's a she's a Delta. And currently, Howard University offers the Norma Merrick Skarlerik Architectural Scholarship Award in her honor. Now this fall, the first public and bookless library is coming to my hometown of San Antonio, Texas. You know, since e-books and digital media are so awesome, you know, who needs actual books? Not us, or apparently not even this library.
Slash sarcasm.
The new book free library called the Bibliotheque, which is a nice little play on the Spanish word for library, biblioteca, will serve as part of the Bexar County's entire bookless public library system, in which the library will lend out e-readers, unknown which brand is going to be, for 2 week periods at a time. The facility will also have computers like any other library, but there's no word on whether they're gonna have a card catalog system. I kinda doubt they really need one. While several academic libraries have toyed with the idea of going bookless for quite a while now, San Antonio is the first to take charge in this new system of libraries that will be bookless from the start. I love my hometown. Also, go Spurs go. Last year's Walking Dead adventure game from Telltale Games was one of the best games from 2012. Even won Game of the Year from a variety of gaming outlets, including the Spike Video Game Awards, which was quite an accomplishment considering that this was, at the time, a downloadable only game. So you know what all that success means? It means it's time to shamelessly milk the license for all it's worth with little effort or respect for the intellectual property. Enter Activision and Terminal Reality's The Walking Dead Survival Instincts first-person shooter game. Now, after presenting a trailer with gameplay demonstration footage that looked as if it was still in pre-alpha stages, with colors and textures were looking very cheap and very plasticky, and there were numerous amounts of screen tearing, and the pace was just kind of off. But you know, I looked at it and I thought, okay, it's early in development, nothing to worry about. They have plenty of time to improve on it, right? 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 Until Activision announced that the game will hit in late March, as in next month. And to further decrease any faith in the final product based on the lackluster gameplay video, Activision released a new trailer with zero gameplay footage, instead having television show stars Norman Reedus and Michael Rooker talking to a camera. You know, kind of like what I'm doing. That's a total LJN move, Activision. Ever since the WWE extended Monday Night Raw from a 2-hour show to 3 hours, they've been having a little bit of difficulty providing entertaining programming to fill the whole show. Here's an idea, WWE. More matches, less segments and interviews. Thank you, Bleacher Report, for suggesting that the WWE reinstate the Cruiserweight, or light heavyweight title if you prefer, the European and the Hardcore Championship titles to help the WWE attempt to maintain some type of solid quality programming on Raw. It's also said that the reintroduction of these three championship titles might assist in creating more dynamic storylines and feuds on Raw, and should SmackDown go 3 hours, that could help as well. The Bleacher Report also provides some brief histories of each of these championships and some interesting facts and other tidbits on each championship title, from, you know, from glorious facts, embarrassing factoids, and random factoids. I like the word factoids. Who's up for more wrestling? I know I am. You too. Good. Well, thank you for tuning in, everyone. Now, please show some love and like the episode. Share it with your friends and family. Add it to your favorites and subscribe to the Practitioner channel. And if you yourself have an opinion or something to share and or add to any of these stories I just mentioned today, feel free to leave it in the comments down below. Be sure to check out thepractitioner.com for further details on these stories. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Pinterest at Practitioner. And you can find me on a variety of other social networks as well. So guys, stay true to yourselves, stay blessed, and stay nerdy. And I'll see you guys next week.